Hello, everyone. My name is Evie, and I'd like to start off my talk with a question. How did you wake up this morning? Did you gently open your eyes, take a deep breath in, and think, wow, I am ready to start my day? Or did your morning look a little more like mine? I know I was jarred awake by my obnoxiously loud alarm clock. I hit snooze for the fourth time, only to realize that I already had to rush if I wanted to make it on time. Mornings are tough because I often don't get enough sleep, and I'm sure many of you have also experienced this waking up on the wrong side of the bed. But beyond a few grumpy mornings, is this really something we need to be concerned about? Well, let's look at the research. One study showed that nearly 70% of students don't get enough sleep on the average school night, so we're definitely not alone. Another study limited students to only 6 hours of sleep per night. After just a few days of this, students showed poor grades and were more anxious, tense, stressed, and angry at regular situations. They showed exaggerated responses to small triggers. Difficulty regulating emotions in this way can trigger pre-existing vulnerabilities to clinical mood disorders like anxiety and depression, many of which emerge during the adolescent years. So this sounds like bad news for student health, but it's also bad news for academics. Students with less sleep showed difficulty developing efficient study strategies. They showed poor memory, difficulty paying attention in class, and had less motivation to learn. So clearly, this is bad news for student health and academics. And I say something needs to change. We need students to snooze more in order to succeed. So there's two ways to get students to sleep more. They could either go to bed earlier in the evening, or we can let them sleep in later in the morning. Let's tackle these one at a time, starting with having students sleep earlier in the evening, which for many teenagers is more easily said than done. And here's why. This is melatonin. Melatonin is a hormone that helps regulate our sleep cycle. When darkness falls, melatonin production increases, making us feel sleepy and want to go to bed. However, as puberty progresses, melatonin switches on later at night. So for a teenager trying to go to bed early, melatonin production hasn't increased, and they might not feel sleepy at all. They might lie awake or not want to go to bed. So this shows that having students going to bed early might not be the most efficient strategy in terms of their biology. So let's look at the flip side, a really exciting alternative, letting students sleep in the morning. I was really excited about this, but I turned to science to see if it would actually help students. And it did. So one study looked at over 7,000 students whose school board changed from a 7:15 a.m. to an 8:40 start time. After this change, students showed higher grades, they had more motivation to learn, and they showed fewer depressive symptoms. So it improved their grades and their academics. Another study replicated these findings, but with a smaller change in start time, just from 8 to 8:30 a.m. Even this small change, just half an hour, had students sleeping over 45 minutes more per night and going to bed 20 minutes earlier, even though school started a little later. So this is fantastic news. And if it were up to me, I'd just leave it at that. No more morning classes, everyone gets to sleep in. But unfortunately, it's not that simple. There are barriers that schools face to switching around their start times. For example, there are school bus times have to be coordinated across a region to facilitate pickups and drop-offs, as well as sports tournaments and other regional competitions have to be scheduled by school board and region, making it difficult for a single school to change their start times. But fortunately, educators and lawmakers have started to listen to what science has to say, and they're taking this into consideration. Laws are in the works to financially support school districts who want to make this positive change and delay start times for their students. But these changes are gradual and slow because they're systemic. There's lots of things that we can do right now to address this issue, and it starts with education. We need teachers, doctors, and educators work closely with students and parents as well. And it's in part their responsibility to make student mental and physical health, including sleep, a priority in the home and classroom. And above all, we need to educate students themselves. A cool example of this is a grade 10 biology sleep curriculum, just a brief addition to the biology curriculum that addresses the biology of sleep that's been introduced to grade 10 classes, so they can learn about the importance of sleep and the dangers of not getting enough. Similar curricula are being developed for children in elementary and middle school as well. So let's get educated. We need students to snooze more in order to succeed. And I hope the sun will soon set on sleepy students, giving them a new chance to be motivated, alert, awake, and excited to begin. But remember, you need a snooze if you want to succeed.